Hello guys, this is Christos, and today we are going to have a talk about file security, and more specifically how to verify that a downloaded file that it belongs to the original developer that provided it, and it's not a modified file that a bad person is using to hack your workstation or use it as a zombie in a botnet, or just encrypt your files and ask for ransom. When a developer creates a file, it creates an MD5 hash. MD5 hash is like the digital fingerprint of a file. As with all such hashing algorithms, there is theoretically an unlimited number of files that will have any given MD5 hash. However, it is very unlikely that any two non-identical files in the real world will have the same MD5 hash, unless they have been, of course, specifically created to have the same hash. Let's go a little bit practical and see what I mean with each file has its own hash. First of all, to verify the hash of a file, you have to use a MD5 verification program that is able to calculate the MD5 hash algorithm of the file you want to verify. I'm using this specific one, MD5 and SHA checksum utility 2.1. I will put the file, the link of the website from the developer in the description. Let's go and I will put this. I think it's this one. Yeah. So it's bhoover.com. This is a file that I verify that it works and it's safe to download it. So you can verify your files. So let's see what how can we use the MD5 hash file and verify algorithm and verify a file. I have downloaded two files here for you. Linux Mint and FileZilla. And let's see how can we verify the file. Let's go Linux Mint. So we want to download Linux OS to use for to our workstation. So we go to download links. We have the links here, blah blah blah. Release size 1.7. Okay, we can verify by the size. And then we have authenticity. Don't forget to verify your ISO. So we select the version of our file. And here are the instructions how to check it from the Linux, from Linux OS, create a directory, blah, 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 blah. Usually, they provide us with a file that it contains the hash algorithm, so we can verify if we are working for Windows or macOS or whatever operating system we are using. So if we open the file, we can see the unique MD5 hash for the file that the developer originally provided, is providing to us. Also, something else I want you to check here is that the MD5 can be encrypted with a different algorithm. So here we have 256 bits encryption. It can be 128 or SHA-1 or different types of encryption. But here they are using SHA-256 sub. As you can see, its version has different hash algorithm. And of course, because it's different file size, different it's different files, and each file has its unique hash algorithm, as we said before. So let's see, ours is Linux Mint 18.1 Cinnamon 64-bit ISO. So how can we verify? We open our utility here. We drag and drop or browse the file, and it calculates the hash algorithm for each of the encryptions that can be possibly used. So this utility can calculate simply MD5, SHA1, SHA256, and 512. So here we have our hash generated. So for this version, the 64-bit, we can see that the 256 mint is using, it's, let's take the four last digits, 9E3C. Let's go, 64, 9E3C. And we can verify by reading all this, but the most easier thing to do is to copy and paste it here. This is an ease that this specific utility can provide to us, so we can verify. So we see it's matched, and the file is an original file that from the developer. So this is a file that is originate from the developer, and it's safe to use. Let's go and see the second file I have downloaded, FileZilla. Download FileZilla. Let's see if we can see where we can verify. It needs a little bit. Let's see from here. No. Additional. Blah, blah, blah. Mozilla information. Aha. And here we have the SHA 512 hash. Let's copy this. And let's verify our file. Drag and drop. And we see very easily and quicker this time. Verified. This is happening because of the file size. If we check the size here, it's 6.75 megabytes, and this one is 1.7 gigabytes. So it's easier to calculate the algorithm. So let's copy, paste, and verify. Has done not much. Okay. Let's see why. 91cc. Download it, we'll set up. Did I copy this? The correct one. Let's see. Paste. There's not much. Okay, let's see what is happening here. This has to 23, 26, 2, green, 64. Tap bundle. Course, because this is a different version. This is setup bundled 2.exe. Let's download this again. You see, with this MD5 verification, we saw that the file that we downloaded from the website, the original website, the website of the creator, is totally different than the one I downloaded from, I think it was from chip.de or something like this. So easily, we figured out that this is a different file. And it is, you see, a different file. That could be something modified to harm the our workstation. That was nice that happened now. So you saw that how useful is this to verify that we have downloaded something that it came from the developer direct and not something that is modified. Because as I can see now here from more options, as you can see in this website, that is the developer that creates FileZilla, it hasn't contained any file that is named Win64 Setup Bundled. So what I guess is that this file has to be something bundled with another free program that generates advertisements, or you never know what. So let's paste this here. Verify, pop, that's. So if you care about security, if you care what you're installing in your operating system, if you care not to be someone's slave, bot, zombie, bitch online, then please always verify the downloaded files. And that's all, and I'll see you next time to another video. Thank you.